Purge series. Now, recently, The Purge, everybody knows that movie series. What happens is once a year for 12 hours, everything is legal. You can kill, you can rape, you can murder, you can pillage, you can do whatever you want. It's all legal. And now this has apparently brought down crime. It has brought down poverty. It has brought down unemployment. And apparently,
because it's brought down the population.
Well, just because all the poor people get killed. That's pretty much, you can't afford a good gun, the rich people can, and then they can kill you. So, yeah, this movie just recently, it was announced that they are going to do a third installment. It is already in production. It looks like it's going to come out sometime in 2015. And so that will be actually the third year in a row that a Purge movie's come out. Now, Purge 1 did make it onto the Horrible Movie of the Week. I believe Ryan Celsius actually gave us that one. So thanks, Ryan. And if you don't know who Ryan Celsius is, just type it into YouTube. You'll see lots of his cool videos. But, yeah, so watch that one. Pretty horrible. And then the second one, I just watched recently. I was entertained. I mean, I'm not saying it was a great movie. Maybe 3 out of 5. But it went better from the first. It, like, got a whole extra, you know, Chewbacca chainsaw over the first. And I kind of like this idea. It's not that I want to ever see this be put into practice in real life, but as a movie series, there's so much things you can do with it. I mean, you could take it anywhere. You could go to multiple cities. You could go with multiple characters. And, you know, I'm just thinking that this is going to be, hopefully, a better version of the Saws, because, you know, Saw is a movie that came out like 7 years in a row. We had to have 7 of them. After number 2, they were all horrendous. Right?
Yeah. The first one was pretty much the best, I thought. And then it was just, let's do another. Let's do another. Okay, do we still have some money? Yeah, we got some money from the last one.
Well, it only cost them like $10 million to make them, and they would always make like $50 million, so why not do it, you know?
Yeah.
So it didn't cost, after the first
two. I think
they
had a few of those that just went straight to DVD or something, too. So.
Yeah, and still made them money, so, you know, why not? And then you had the Paranormal Activity series, which I think they went through, what, 4 or 5 installments?
Mm-hmm.
And that, again,
I mean,
was...
Horror movies do that a lot. They just go through, they just churn them out.
But year after year after year. So now it's looking like The Purge is going to be the next set of installment movies, and I'm kind of cool with it, you know? Like I said, the second one was a lot better than the first. And they decided to take it out of rich person land and throw you into the city and show you all this chaos, and I kind of got the vibe from this movie that it's almost like a zombie movie. I mean, you got the vibe of a zombie movie, a group of survivors trying to make it across the city with all these obstacles in their way. But instead of it being, you know, the slow zombies or the fast zombies, you had real live people. So I kind of like it.
And you had the sense of, like, someone actually, you know, like, characters choosing to do something for each other.
Mm-hmm.
You know, almost like there's a hero in that. And, like, the first one, it's just, like, a kid randomly decides to help one guy because...
Well, and then the movie just takes the
And then it's just Survivor. Turn. Survive, yeah.
Well,
after that,
no,
as opposed
it takes
to...
the stupidest turn. And it's just... I mean, the first one was just... It had a great cast to it. Ethan Hawke, Lena Headey. I mean, but it was just a horrible movie. It made the Horrible Movie of the Week for a reason. But The Purge 2, it made you... It put some suspense into it. They had these really crazy gang of kids in the masks, and they were really, really creepy masks. You had this weird government truck running around, and government's doing shady things during this Purge time. So they brought in a lot of cool ideas, but it's like I said, it's giving you the vibe of a zombie movie, but it has the potential to give you a lot more substance. Not only do you have the vibe of the zombie, but you can kind of get some themes. You know, if you've ever heard of a decent proposal, that is one of the first examples of satire out in the world, where an English writer, everybody was like, what do we do about the Irish? Because they subjected them all to poverty from the... England pretty much stole all the resources.
A modest proposal?
Modest proposal, that's what I meant to say. Yeah, and then they said, well, what do we do about all the Irish? Well, let's eat their babies. Or make them eat their own babies. You know, funny, you know, satire. And it almost gives you a good... version of satire with these movies, because it's like, okay, government, what do we do with the poor people? Oh, let's just kill them all, you know? And I really like the way this is going, and I could see there being like... Now, this would be kind of my hope was what they do with it, is bring out some sort of like superhero. Maybe not somebody with powers, but like...
Someone who goes around and helps people during the purge.
Maybe. Yeah, and there is one guy in The Purge, too. There is a guy. He's kind of the reluctant hero, which I like that, too. But he helps out these guys. But I would almost like to see, like, a guy, like a Batman, like, flying around only during Purge night.
Yeah, and with that setup, you can almost see progress over the course of the series of, you know, starting to maybe get groups of people that kind of don't approve of the Purge and try to actually resist people, like kill people.
They do kind of do that. They do kind of bring in Omar from The Wire, a great actor. He becomes one of those types of characters. But I'm saying you could do just totally different things every movie. I mean, if you're going to make it a yearly installment, you can do one where it's like some kids get stuck out during the Purge and they get out, or some old people, or, you know, it could be on the ocean. It could be, you know, you could do tons of different things. You could look from it from the government trying to call the population. I mean, and that's what I like about it, because there's so many different possibilities for this movie series that they can, if they try, and it does not have to be big budget. I mean, you're talking about a basic cityscape. You don't have to have much to it. And it could be a decent series. So I'm kind of looking forward to it. I hope it develops into something that I will continually want to watch. Not like the first one.
I would say that it seems like they have two paths they can go. Either one seems like a good idea. One, if they decide to just be, if they want to just be a horror movie style, they can churn these out probably to better effect than a lot of other horror movies, because, like you said, they're not tied really to one person. This is a policy and event, as opposed to a lot of horror movies that are about, you know, single creature, killer, whatever.
Jason, Freddy, you know, those guys.
The Saw killer, whatever, Jigsaw killer, whatever.
Mike Myers.
So there's only so much you can do. You're just churning out the same thing and like, oh, why isn't he got whatever it is. You have to kind of go with the same idea over and over. This is a policy of a day, and it's a very broad policy. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of things you can do, and you can go different characters, like you said, different places, different events. You can even start focusing on different stuff happening. Like, it doesn't have to be all about killing, because a lot of murder happens, but other stuff happens too, because it's just everything's legal.
It's legal. And another thing that I got to say is, like I said, number one to number two, I mean, number two is like twice the movie that number one was. But also they showed that they can really develop characters in that one.
And that's the second route I would say that they could go, is if they don't want to just be jumping around, they could go more of a thriller, more social commentary route, like we were talking about, the satirical side, and either develop characters or just develop a trend throughout where, like I said, like resistance to the Purge, where people start becoming disenchanted with the idea of the Purge, and you can have an end point of overturning it, some kind of revolution, whatever, something going on there, or people really starting to build up, like, taking responsibility to go against the mentality of what the Purge is about. So you could go the either route. You could go the, like, now you develop heroes, like you said, or you could go the route of just, this is a horror movie that shows how different people handle the situation, and you have a wide variety of things you can do in that situation.
And personally, I'm not a horror movie fan. I don't enjoy horror movies very much, so I hope they go more of the, you know, thriller. Okay, let's show some good parts of society. Like I said, they develop a character, and they're like, okay, something good comes out of something horrible. And I'd rather them go that way rather than the whole, oh, let's just put some guys in scary masks and have them hunt down a group and eventually just hack them to pieces. That, you know, the horror movie route. So, I don't know. But let us know what you think. Hit us up. Comments down below. Of course, it's my face on Twitter, wordsmyface@gmail.com. Google+ and Facebook, always good ways to get a hold of us. Do you want this to go the horror route? Or would you rather it go, like, the hero route? Let us know what you think.